This is the Share the Knowledge Podcast for DJs.
And let's start with a question that I received through the live stream, and that was from a DJ who was about to do his first gig, and he wanted to know if I had any suggestions, any tips, and I have plenty. Now, the first thing I told that DJ is to be aware and be prepared for the fact that you will make mistakes. I feel this is very important. A lot of DJs overlook this and they're focusing on perfection, which basically is non-achievable, especially for your first gigs. But DJs, young and old, new and veterans, we all make mistakes. So especially if you're going to do your first gig, you should know that you will make mistakes and that that's perfectly fine. It's how you deal with those mistakes. So if you're prepared, if you know in advance that you're going to make some mistakes and you know that that's okay, then that will not stress you out as much. If you go into that first gig and you're just thinking about nailing that gig, making it a perfect set, everything perfect, perfect delivery, every track is on point, EQ is on point, every transition is flawless. If that's going to be your mindset, then you're going to set yourself up for failure, because by the time you make that first mistake, and it will happen, if you make that first mistake and you were expecting to do a flawless, perfect set, it's going to really upset you, and that's going to affect the rest of your set. So you don't want that to happen. Now, of course, you're going in there and you want to make sure you drop a good set. But making a couple of mistakes can still leave you with a great set. I mean, you can watch sets from professional DJs who are actually mixing live, and here and there, you're going to hear little mistakes. Unless everything was pre-prepared and you name it, if they're doing a live set, especially if they're doing a live freestyle set, you're going to hear small mistakes. It might be a fader that just opens up a little bit too early and then you hear another song, or maybe the transition isn't perfect so they have to adjust a little bit and then get it right. That is part of the natural mixing process and that's perfectly fine. Look, if you're playing in front of people, they're not there to judge your DJ set. They're there to have a good time, enjoy the music, and playing a great track is going to have a lot more, leave a better impression and give a better, give you better feedback than making a flawless transition. Most of the people don't even know how to recognize that flawless transition. So that is not the most important thing. So be prepared to make mistakes. Now, I'm talking about small mistakes, but even if you do a total train wreck during your transition, even if that happens, know that that is something that can happen and keep it moving. Move ahead straight away. So you mix in the second track, somehow you give it a nudge forward when you were supposed to bring it back, and now you got snares like totally out of line and it's a mess. That can happen. Just take that old track out, let the new track play, or take that old track out and try again, but just make sure you switch so we don't hear the two tracks anymore. The crowd might be shocked for a second and just look at the DJ booth for a second, but as soon as they hear that tune, they'll get back into the music and you're fine. I've heard DJs who just panicked and for over like 20 seconds, you were hearing ka, 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 two snares just totally messing up. And then you get the entire crowd looking at it like, what's happening? We can't dance anymore. We're hearing two beats. They're not matched. What's happening? So if you make a major mistake, just switch and keep it moving and focus on the next song. They're there for the music, not for the mixes. So I know that sounds weird, like, hey, you're DJing, you've been practicing all that time, working on your mixing skills, and now I'm telling you that the crowd is not really there for your mixing skills. It's a shame, but it's a fact. People are there. They're having a couple of drinks. They're looking at guys. They're looking at girls. You name it. They're having a good time, enjoying songs. They're not really focused on your mixing skills. So moving on from that, I feel it's very important to make sure you come fully prepared. Now, preparation doesn't mean that you have to prepare your set. That's going to be different for every DJ. You might be a DJ who likes to prepare an entire set, or you might be a DJ who likes to play freestyle and just bring songs and go off the crowd. Both approaches will work. I'm talking about all of the other preparation. So I'll get back to prepared sets in a minute and freestyle sets, but let's just start with doing research and being prepared for the situation you're going to jump into. So, what type of venue is it? What type of people will be attending? What type of music are they expecting? So maybe you already know the venue because you've been there yourself. Then you're already familiar with what the vibe is, what people like, what people don't like, you name it. If you haven't been to that venue before, you might want to try and do some research either by calling or approaching people who do play there or who have played there. And if you don't know anyone, maybe try to find some footage online to see what the vibe and atmosphere there is. And if none of that works, you can still even approach like the promoter or the owner and just ask. If you have time, you can go to the venue before you actually have to play, like a week or two in advance to check it out. But if that's not possible, ask the promoter. So you want to know, does the event have a certain theme? Are they expecting you to play a certain type of music? What's your time slot? Are you warming up? Are you headlining? Are you closing? All of that information will help you to be prepared for what you're there to do. Now, next step in the preparation is making sure your music is prepared. Again, it doesn't matter if you're preparing your set or playing freestyle. When I say preparing your tracks, I mean analyzing all your files, making sure you got your cue points, loops, everything on point, that the names are correct. If you have extra tags in there, that they're tagged. If you have certain folders, that your folders are on point, that you know where to find everything, you name it. That is all prep. And being prepared, so knowing that all of that is in order, will make it much easier to just focus on having a good time and actually playing the music. So research, preparing your music, knowing what to expect, being prepared to possibly make some mistakes. Next up, you might want to consider, if you're playing freestyle, to prepare a couple of short mixes, especially your starting point. So maybe the first two or three tracks are actually a prepared mix. So the start of your set is something you can practice. That way you know that the first two or three transitions are gonna be on point. You pick nice tunes that really hopefully will work for what you're there to do, and practice so you can do that right. If you do those first couple of mixes correctly, you have nice transitions, that's gonna boost your confidence and help you with the rest of the set. Now, if at any point during your set you have that little mental block where you just lose it for a second, you just don't have a good idea of what to do next because you're playing freestyle, but somehow you lose it for a minute, if you have a couple of other short prepared mixes, you can just fall back, just do one of those mixes for two, three tracks, and hopefully that will get you back in there. So those are things that could definitely help you out. Don't forget to have fun. That's very important as well. Don't forget to have fun. Try not to be too stressed about, like I said, making little mistakes and stuff like that. Try to enjoy the music. Hopefully you became a DJ because you love to play music. And I remember I had nerves during my first gigs, but at the same time, hearing the music I love through these big speakers, that's a great feeling. That really is a great feeling. Now, especially if you throw in a track and you get a reaction from the crowd, that is like the ultimate feeling. That's just dope. So don't forget to have fun. Those are just a couple of suggestions to make your first gig go better. One more thing about preparation, make sure you are bringing everything you need to bring. Very important. So if you're playing on your controller, for instance, you need to know in advance if they have that controller at the venue. If not, if it is possible for you to bring your controller, what you need to hook your controller up to their setup. You don't want to end up in a situation where you walk in and they have a DJ booth with no room for your equipment, or you're expecting them to have certain equipment and then they don't have that, they have something else. So make sure You know what is available at the venue. If it's not what you want to use, make sure that you are able to bring your own stuff and connect it. That is also very important. If you know all of those things and you know everything as far as the technical side is okay, then you don't have to worry about that. And again, you can start to focus more on the actual gig, the actual performance. Enjoy your first gig. You just checked out a video clip from my Share the Knowledge podcast. If you want to check out the full audio episodes, you can find me on Anchor, SoundCloud, Spotify, Apple, you name it. Links are in the description box down below, so make sure you check that out. If this is your first time checking out my YouTube channel, I have a lot of DJ-related content, educational content for DJs, tips and tricks, tutorials, reviews, you name it. So make sure you subscribe and activate the notifications so you don't miss out on any of my future videos. See you next time.